entering the arena, please welcome Jesus Sargento Martinez.
We welcome you to our DAZN social channels bonus coverage here to begin a big night of boxing on DAZN. Jesus Martinez making his walk to the ring. Ryan Rucco, Sergio the Latin Snake Mora with you. Martinez 26-9 in his career, 13 knockouts, had a 45-day camp. If you include the time he had been preparing for another scheduled bout, was in training for a different fight, then got the call for this fight, and is ready to take on TJ Dohany.
And now, making his way to the ring, please welcome TJ, the Power Dohany.
Well, TJ Dohany, 21-1, 15 knockouts. His only loss coming in what was a title unification bout against Danny Roman, and he lost by majority decision. A fairly strong showing for Dohany, and now obviously he's seen how quickly the fortunes can change in this world.
No, it was a 2019 Fight of the Year candidate, one of my favorites. It's been one of these fights where Dohany said he could have made it easier, but he made a lot of fans fighting in that fan-friendly style.
Dohany, born in Ireland, moved to Australia, now trains in Massachusetts. His only loss in his career, that bout against Danny Roman, which he said he still plays over in his head over and over again. Said it is not easy to lose a close fight, and this is the first step back on the comeback trail for TJ Dohany.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Wintrust Arena here in Chicago, Illinois, live on DAZN's social media platforms, we are set to go with our next bout of the evening, and it's all being brought to you courtesy of Mr. Eddie Hearn of Matchroom Boxing USA. We're sponsored by William Hill, Core Premium Vodka, Coors Light, Ingrod, and JD Sports. Introducing your three judges scoring this contest from ringside, Al Gallardo, Gary Cruz, and Alan Rosin. At the sound of the bell, your third man in the ring, referee David Smith. And now, ladies and gentlemen, eight rounds of boxing scheduled in the super bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, standing with his head trainer, Elfracio Gonzalez. He wears the camouflage trunks, his southpaw scaled at 124 pounds. His professional record, 26 victories, 9 defeats. He has 13 wins coming by way of knockout. Fighting out of Hollywood, Florida, by way of Monterrey, Colombia. He's the former Colombian and South American super flyweight champion. Introducing Jesus Sargento Martinez. Martinez. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner. He stands with his head trainer, Hector Bermudez. He wears the white with red. He's also a southpaw, and he also scaled at a ready at even 124 pounds. His professional record, excellent. 21 victories, only one defeat, 15 wins coming by way of knockout. Fighting out of Bondi Junction, Australia, by way of Portlaoise, Ireland. Introducing the former IBF Junior Featherweight Champion of the World, TJ the Power Dohany. Dohany.
David Smith, now a referee, will give the rules. TJ Dahany and Jesus Martinez.
All right, gentlemen, you both know the rules. Give me a good clean fight, start to finish. Touch them up, step back, let's do it. Touch them up.
8 rounds at super bantamweight for TJ Dahany and Jesus Martinez. As Dahany looks to get some positive thoughts in his head after the loss to Danny Roman.
Yeah, he wants to get that momentum back. He says he wants to get him under them lights, get the feel for punches, and get back that title that he
lost.
Let's
go.
One of the things that Dahany said he regrets about that fight against Roman is he knew an efficient way to box and win, but felt like he was sort of tempted into brawling more than he should have and was hearing the crowd a bit and has sort of vowed to shoo that away because he knows his instincts want to just stand there and fight, but he also knows it's not the wise way to approach things. That's a wise way to start. A ferocious left hand from Dahany as it almost sends Jesus Martinez down, just caught on the ropes, and a first round knockdown from Dahany.
Well, they call him the power, so he does have some pop behind that punch, especially coming from that southpaw stance. But back to what you were talking about, Ryan. Yeah, he made that fight with Daniel Roman really difficult because he got caught in the momentum of the Mexican fans cheering his name. He said he made a lot of Mexican fans that night, but he ended up losing the world title.
Right hand to the body from Dahany. Martinez flailing up top with a combination.
Break, break.
Martinez has been stopped 5 times in his career. He has never won a fight outside of Colombia.
Martinez fighting out of the southpaw stance. He's an orthodox fighter. Right now he's fighting lefty, just like Power Doheny.
Dahany didn't know this fight was definitely happening until about 10 days ago. As he gets Martinez up against the ropes. Nice combination to the body from Dahany.
Good body shots. Over the top, needs to watch out with that punch. Dahany already got caught twice with that overhand left from Martinez.
A reminder, we have an outstanding night of boxing on DAZN. Make sure to purchase the app and catch Alexander Usyk's heavyweight debut this evening.
Watch out, watch out.
Dahany. Strong left hand to the body as he and Martinez claw away. Final 10 seconds of the first round.
Check back of the head. Time!
Well, TJ Dahany did what he needed to do in that opening round.
Yeah, he said he wanted to get under them lights again, get hit with those small gloves, and he definitely got hit in that first round, but it was a pretty good feel-out round for Martinez, I gotta say. He landed some good overhand lefts.
Every time you go on offense, you gotta make sure.
And there's a good shot by Dahany.
What's coming back at you?
I mean, that's what he wanted to do. He wants to get hit with these small gloves and get under the lights. Now it's time to initiate the game plan. So here we're gonna see a good left hand landed. Martinez took it well, right on the chin. Went down, the ropes held him up there. It was kind of a weird combination. He stepped in with a right hand and came over the top with a left. I don't think Martinez expected that. It was more of a flash knockdown, but still a knockdown.
Let's go.
Start of round number 2 between TJ Dahany and Jesus Martinez. 7 fights to come on DAZN tonight, ending with Alexander Usyk's heavyweight debut. Dahany Trying to dive at the body with that jab as Martinez swings wildly over the top.
Good overhand left there by Don. He was setting that up with two feints, backing Martinez up. Finally caught him against the ropes, and he unleashed it, landed nicely. Back comes Martinez right there. He threw it from a little bit too far. He fell off balance there. And Martinez doesn't have the best balance either. He's mostly flat-footed, so he doesn't want to miss too much.
Martinez is actually an active member of the Colombian Army. Splits his training between Colombia and Miami. Scheduled 8-round bout here between Dahani and Martinez.
Push that head down.
We asked Dahani, what's the game plan for this fight? He said, well, I'm going to have to chase him all night. He backs up a lot. So I'm going to have to corner him, jab, get some good body shots, and get him against the ropes and unleash.
What do you think? Is Martinez moving around as he anticipated?
Actually, I thought he was going to be more flat-footed. The videos I've seen of Martinez, he was a little bit flat-footed, but he's backing up nicely. I think he respects Dahani's power there. That was a push-down.
No knockdown there.
No. One more.
Dahani in the white and red trunks.
Look at me. Nod your head. Let's go.
And Martinez in the camouflage trunks. Dahani being worn there by referee David Smith. Martinez misses with that big overhand left.
Martinez doesn't have the best balance, so I would avoid throwing those overhand lefts unless he sets them up. That's where his game is going to be, is touching him to the body. Right there, you can't miss. At least you're going to land. But that overhand left he just missed right there, he's going to be susceptible to Dahani's power and counter shots.
See if Dahani can take advantage.
Off his head. Let's go. He's heavy to the bar. He's gassing. Heavy to the bar. That's all.
Martinez misses again with a wild left.
10 seconds, guys.
Good left right there by Martinez, going backwards.
Time!
A little less activity in round number two from Dahani.
I think he's respecting Martinez a little bit too much right here. Martinez is boxing pretty well off the back foot.
Tírame los pies, tírame los pies, tírame los pies. Ven, Jesús, tienes que tirarme doble a ese. Está olvidando un poquito la mano adelante. Y la izquierda, acompáñame. Muy buen. La reacción que está metiendo. ¿Okay?
Ya va bajando la rapidez.
Claro, yo sé que está bajando. ¿Eh?
His speed is slowing down there.
Sí. Entonces quiero que trabaje más ahora ese doble ya.
I want you to work your jab a little bit more.
La izquierda tuya. ¿Está oyendo?
And your left hand. The left hand is the key. ¿Eh? Everything good? Good.
Izquierda y cruzado. Ciérrate.
Throw your 1-2,
si te metes los
think
at
the
parado,
counter.
Parado, y lo, el swing es recto, abajo, para abajo, ¿me está oyendo? Ya come los
percú de él. Doble Watch ya. Out for the uppercut. Watch out
doble
for the uppercut.
Doble ya.
Start of round number three between TJ Dahani and Jesus Martinez. Sergio, you're in a fight like this. I mean, how much urgency, if you're Dahani, do you feel to just get Martinez out of there early and in
no,
impressive
no.
fashion?
You know what? Right? Actually, no. He's had some time off. Dahani's had some time off.
Right,
he knew
right,
where
right.
he went
back,
wrong in the Roman fight. He let the crowd, the sound of the crowd, get the best of him. He says, I should have stunk up the place. Maybe I could have became a unified champion. So he knows through experience now that you need to slow down in there. You need to land the right shots with precision and pop. And that's what I think he's doing here. Still being aggressive, but being smart aggressive.
Nice combination there from Dahani as he got Martinez up against the ropes. Martinez has fought 6 times already this year. So if nothing else, he's not rusty as he nearly lost his footing there.
See, that's what I don't want Martinez to do. He doesn't have the best balance, and he's kind of a flat-footed fighter. So if you have clumsy feet and balance issues, you don't want to throw overhand lefts and rights like that. You want to set those up, punching combinations.
Off his head. Let arm go. Stop, stop, stop. Bucks.
Good body shot right there by Martinez. Back comes Doheny with two body shots.
Head.
See?
Stop.
Yeah, and once again,
stop.
Martinez started to lose the footing a little bit there. A reminder that at 7 Eastern, we will start our card for the evening on the DAZN app. Make sure to download to watch. An evening that will end with Alexander Usyk's heavyweight debut.
Bucks.
Which I know we're both looking forward to.
Absolutely, that's pound for pound one of the great fighters of our era. And making a big step to the heavyweight division.
And the first of our 7 fights is one fight fans are jazzed up for. Charles Conwell against Patrick Day.
Yep. 2016 Olympian, U.S. Olympian, and an Olympic alternate. That'll be a really good fight.
Martinez trying to swing at the body. Doheny comes right back at him.
See, Martinez is going to be game. He's been in there with some good competition. He's a veteran of 35, 40 fights. But he's been stopped 5 times. Anytime a fighter's been stopped that many times, you just got to get out of these early rounds because they're going to be game. But then you break them down in the middle rounds, and that's when you start looking for the stoppage if you're Doheny.
Nice body work from Doheny.
Time!
And the end of round number 3. We have a scheduled 8.
Good job, TJ. Look, just keep getting that work, man.
You're busting them up.
Keep some water. Keep being aware. You're doing good.
Hector Bermudez, the trainer for TJ Doheny.
I need better body.
And here's Doheny landing some really good body work. And this is exactly what Doheny is really good at, breaking down fighters to the body, like he did in his fight with Ryoshi Takahashi. That's
I don't need no
how you break down fighters to the body.
Right, when you throw punches, smother everything else. Right? I don't like you pulling back. How right, you doing good? Dude.
Don't push that head down. Let's go.
Start of the 4th round between Doheny and Martinez. Doheny, formerly a scaffolder, 2017, was broke, almost quit boxing. At one point, didn't have the money to buy his kid a Christmas present, but kept plugging away and found himself as a world champ after going to Japan to win the IBF belt in August of 2018. Before surrendering that belt in his last bout, a unification fight against Danny Roman.
Swinging and missing right there, Martinez. He does not want to do that. He has horrible balance. He needs to set those up with jabs. And that, there you go. Go downstairs with the jab. Make sure you touch something. Then you can come around with the body shots.
Instead, leaving himself open quite a bit.
Stop! Stop! Step back. Let's go.
A couple of southpaw fighters going at it.
It's always awkward when a left-handed fighter fights another left-handed fighter. They're not used to seeing each other's styles. They're used to having the advantage of being a southpaw.
Stop! 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 Stay off his hat. Come on, head up, head up. Let's go, let's go. Turn around, turn, step back, step back. Turn around.
David Smith has had to warn Doheny a few times about that.
Doheny's like, let me go. I want to keep fighting.
No knockdown. No knockdown.
No knockdown there.
Shut up. You're good. You're good. Do not push him down. Do not down him. Let's go.
Once again, Doheny reminded not to push down Martinez. Martinez takes a stiff left hand to the head. And some body work from Doheny as Martinez covers up.
Yeah, go ahead, guys. Let's go that arm.
Doheny working in close quarters as Martinez backs up against the ropes.
I think TJ's starting to break down
Martinez
here, and it's the body shots that do it.
Time, time. Come over here, both you guys. not push his head down. You're going to lose a point. I warn you again. Your head up. Let's go. Time in. Bucks.
David Smith has had to continue to instruct Dahani about that. Came at an inopportune time for Dahani as it started to break down Martinez.
Break, break, break. Step back. Step back, guys. Good job. Let's go.
And down goes Martinez again, not a knockdown.
Head up, head up.
Martinez continuing to complain about Dahani holding down his head.
Don't lose a point on this, DJ. 10 seconds, guys. Head up.
Body shot on Martinez. Dahani barely missing with a big left hand that probably would have put Martinez down really cleanly there.
You know what? We've seen a lot of verbiage from David Smith in this fight. Let's get the perspective of Hall of Fame rules analyst for us, Steve Smoger. Steve, what have you seen thus far in this fight with what's going on with Dahani and grasping at Jesus Martinez?
It looks to me that boxer Martinez is looking for a way out with the constant complaining. I don't think the work of Dahani in any way deserved a warning of that nature, and it was inopportune. It looked like he was closing in. And I think that David should allow them to fight and decide the issue themselves.
Great perspective, Steve.
Stay behind that jab, right?
Thank you.
A lot of feints, a lot of jabs.
And that's the thing about the timing of it, Sergio. As you said, it seemed like Jesus Martinez had just begun to come unraveled.
Yeah, and Donnie's breaking him down. And it's only Hall of Fame eyes that Steve Smoger can notice that Martinez is breaking down. And he is looking for a way out. And when you start complaining to the referee, you're looking for excuses and a way out. We're going to see right now if he still has fight left. But I love that analysis by Smoger.
Steve, are we with us all night? 7 fights coming up on DAZN. Make sure you download the app. It'll end with Alexander Usyk's heavyweight debut. Dahani flags down Martinez, throws a left hand to the body. Good right jab from Dahani. Counter to left from Dahani catches as well.
Good body shot by Martinez there. He's been landing that left hand on Dahani right there, but it hasn't really had much effect. DJ Dahani keeps coming forward, cutting off the ring, and landing some brutal body shots of his own.
Dahani, combination to the body, and then a few more.
That's what I want to see from Dahani, is speed instead of power. Even though they call him power Dahani, but he needs to work on speed and angles and get on an angle. If you're a left-hander, you got to get on an angle, and then that's where you land the real power shots, the ones that surprise your opponent.
Martinez trying to dance away from Dahani. Dahani once again looking to cut off the ring as he peppers Martinez with a hard left hand to the body.
Yeah, Martinez, his body's not looking too sharp to me right now. A little bit fluid, trying to turn his back on Dahani right there. I don't know how much he's going to want to continue fighting here.
Dahani, strong left hand up top from Dahani. Martinez flails into the corner. And that'll be the second knockdown of the fight for TJ Dahani.
It's body language on my part here. I don't like Martinez's body language. Looking at his corner, already dropped twice. I don't know how much longer this is going to continue.
Let's go, turn around.
Would you let him continue it if you were his corner?
It's all up to Martinez, but Martinez's body language is not really telling me anything. He's looking at his corner, looks confused, getting knocked down.
He's down again, and that was not a knockdown, a slip.
It's not the body language of a fighter that wants to continue, especially when you're in there with a former champion like Dahani. But like I said, Martinez's game early in these rounds, but then he starts getting broken down, and the true colors come out.
Dahani trying to land a couple more. Big uppercut from Dahani as Martinez goes stumbling into his corner at the end of the fifth round.
¿Qué te pasa?
No, no voy más.
¿No va más? ¿Seguro? ¿No? ¿Eh?
No, no, no voy más.
¿Quedan dos rounds?
¿Cómo? ¿Qué duro?
¿Sí?
Sí.
¿Ya te pasó la pelea?
Sí, me acaba.
Jesús Martínez wants the corner to stop the fight, and they're stopping the fight.
Hey, oh my God.
What did he tell you?
Well, now Jesús Martínez has been stopped in three of his last eight bouts, and TJ Dahany back on the winning track after the loss to Danny Roman.
And good call by Hall of Fame referee Steve Smoker. He knew the body language, and he was right. Martinez didn't want to continue. A fighter and a referee with that much experience knows when a fighter wants to continue, and Martinez started off strong, but you could tell that the body shots started taking their toll, and once you can't hurt your man, especially a former champion in Dahany, that's when you look for a way out.
What'd you think of the performance from Dahany tonight?
It was a good comeback fight, and it was a good comeback fight versus a veteran with a lot of fights, but he has been stopped five times. He's 38 years old. He's supposed to stop guys like this. But it was an accumulation of body shots, overhand lefts. It was just a matter of time right there for David Smith to look for a reason to stop this fight, but it was Martinez's corner that ended up stopping the fight.
So that final uppercut just before the bell of the fifth round, which sent Martinez stumbling into his corner. And that was all she wrote. So TJ Dahany will improve to 22-1 with 16 knockouts.
No, he did. That's what you need to do. You need,
as we send things up to David Diamante.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 1 second of round number six. Your winner by TKO from Port Lee, Ireland, TJ the Power Dahany.
Well, TJ Dahany, the knockout after five rounds, improves to 22-1. In his first fight since losing a title unification bout against Danny Roman.